Sheboat and Husky Harris have had personal issues for weeks, and Dream, in my opinion, at the heart of it all, at the heart of everything that's been going on between these two, is Oksana.
Yeah, I think it's called for me. Again, so that goes back with Bo. It goes back with young Bo Rotundo, and then brother against brother, and then we got here. Here's where we're at.
His opponent from Brooksville, Florida, weighing 290 pounds, Husky Harris.
Here we are indeed. This is Falls Count Anywhere, and folks, Dream said it. They can take a fall in the lobby. They can pin somebody outside on the floor. Anything goes. There's really no rules, except the finish of this match is going to occur when one man pins the other man anywhere in the FCW arena, pretty much anywhere in Tampa, Florida.
Yeah, I think we're ready to go with this too, buddy. I mean, this thing will be pretty.
Steamboat and Husky, I'm surprised they're showing restraint right now. I mean,
well, you got to kind of take a step back and see what you got yourself into. They both wanted this thing. Maxine did a great job of putting it together. So, y'all want to fight? Let's get after it. Let's get after tonight right here.
Last week, that triple threat match for the Florida Heavyweight Championship, Richie Steamboat super kicked Husky Harris, which caused Husky to tap out to Leo Kruger's sleeper hold submission. And now, after that match, Richie and Husky were fighting all over the FCW arena. And right now, Richie's really taking it to Husky.
I think Richie's doing the right thing right here, keeping him inside there, because it's a pinfall. That's it. You take it anywhere, might as well take it, as you said, cliche-wise, in the middle of the ring.
Husky Harris has got to utilize his power advantage, and Richie's really got to watch out, because Husky at 290 pounds, so dangerous with every move that he makes. Steamboat very accomplished in the ring, though. Man, hard shot from Husky.
Richie being second generation, I'm going to tell you what, man. This is the old saying, this ain't my daddy's Oldsmobile, you know what I'm talking about?
Husky going for an early pinfall attempt right now.
You didn't answer me. Did you get that? Did you pick that up?
There's a lot of stuff I don't pick up. There's a lot of stuff that just goes right over my head.
And you act like you're going somewhere up north or something.
Oh, you never know. Husky Harris trying to put Richie Steamboat through the canvas, utilizing that ample posterior and now a knee right across the throat. Once again, everything's legal in this matchup. The referee there only to count a three fall.
Well, you brought up a good point right there. When you're out there and you're just saying, well, they need to maybe get somebody in here, that he's in there. All he's got to do is count one, two, three. I don't care where they go or what they do. Like I said, it could happen right here in the ring. If it happens there, that's cool. It's clean. But I don't know. I believe they're working themselves up in a ladder. You know what I mean? Richie Steamboat. Let me just say one thing. Richie Steamboat got a great upside. Outweighed, too, in this thing right here. But he's got a mean streak in him that I didn't see when I first met him. And it's starting to come out just a little bit. So if a woman calls it, sometimes it's for the better.
Oksana has been at the heart of so much controversy here in FCW, and her influence continues, even if her presence is not visible. You gotta know, Oksana's on the mind not only of Husky Harris, but Richie Steamboat. Husky hooks
got
the leg right now.
No, she played Kiss the Face with both of them, you know what I mean? And the brother.
Absolutely.
So, I mean, that's a Taj Mahal right there.
This all started months ago when Oksana took interest in the former Florida heavyweight champion, Bo Rotundo. Husky took exception to that. And then Oksana, once again, as you said, just playing her role to perfection. She is manipulating and spinning her webs here in FCW.
I tell you what, though, outside here, Richie's in no man's land, because this big old brute right here is used to brawling.
Into the steel barricade.
There you go.
Steamboat firing back.
I ain't the one, but what I mean, when I see something good, I call.
Steamboat with a chop, and Husky Harris now down. And they are out there, and there's about a quarter inch of padding over the cement floor here in the FCW arena. Such a dangerous position. Husky's got his head in the apron here. Richie Steamboat.
He got his head in the apron. You are killing me.
Oh, Richie hard into the steps.
Wow, man, that's a blow right there to your back.
Flesh and bone meeting the steel.
But I said, Matt, too, he's got him out there in a bad way, out there to where Richie's not really, used to being in a brawl like this. I don't know if you get second thoughts sometimes. But right here, go for a pin.
Richie kicks out, and I got to agree with you. Husky's probably more likely to be used to these kinds of situations. Being in a straight-up fight, this is not a technical match. You haven't seen exactly a lot of hammerlock reversals or anything like that. This is a straight-up one-on-one fight. Yeah. These guys giving it all they have.
Yeah, they are, buddy. I'm telling you, they bring it to it. That's what makes SCW and the WWE developmental system so great, man. Young kids trying to fight their way up, and right here they're in a situation to where, uh-oh, it's moving now into a different plane, you know what I'm saying?
We are coming into the entranceway, and this is where Husky and Richie ended up last week after that triple threat Florida Heavyweight Championship match, and it ended in disaster, basically. We had to get superstars and officials out here to pull these two apart. Is this gonna become the same kind of a situation? But it's all legal. All legal right now. This pinfall could happen right there on the forum. Right into the steel barricades again, and nobody here is safe. Not our ring announcer, not our official. Husky trying to put Richie away.
Tried to pin him twice, tried to pin him both times on the floor, it didn't work. I gotta give it to Richie Steamboat. Reaching way down right now. No, he's in a fight. No, he's in a ballroom brawl. No, he's in a brawl, period.
Oh! Well, that'll turn the tables in a hurry.
Yeah, that'll change your mind about singing high, you know what I'm saying?
Husky Harris.
Yeah, he got him down now. Well, he need to pound on him, get a cover.
Oh, Richie hooking the leg right now. No, Husky able to kick out, but what damage was done after that low blow by Steamboat? That's very uncharacteristic, but as you said, Steamboat's really got more of an edge to him.
Oh, buddy, here we go.
Outside here, and it's not too often we see our competitors fight on the outside, but when it is, it's unbelievable.
That's what I'm talking about.
Harris, these are concrete steps. These are steel banisters right here. This is incredibly, incredibly dangerous.
I'm going to tell you what, they're taking it to the streets. When you talk about taking it out to the streets, that's what's going on right here.
This has devolved into a street fight. Absolutely.
Well, we talked about this. We said it's going to break loose. Referee's still out there trying to get in control.
I gotta give credit to our cameramen. They're putting themselves in danger's way. They could get taken out. Anybody is a risk right now. You see our official out there. He's ready to make a three count if a pinfall occurs outside here at FCW. Husky is being pushed into that steel pipe out there.
And I'm gonna tell you what, man. Richie Steamboat is taking control of what's going on. He understands where he's at.
Oh, Husky fighting back. I think Husky caught Richie in the knee and managed to land a punch right to the side of the face.
Well, it's dangerous out here, man. This is really dangerous.
And fatigue has got to be setting in at this point. These guys have gone all over the FCW arena. You see the sweat pouring from their bodies. These guys have putting all of their physical exertion into this matchup. Husky reversed. Oh, he must have crashed into the wall there.
I gotta say, Husky, you're putting up a pretty good fight.
Steamboat saying, stay down.
Yeah.
Just give up.
Beating him and talking to him.
Oh, kick right.
Beating him and talking to him.
Right to the gut. And you see the FCW Universe has rushed outside to see what's going on. And Dream, I think this is your line, but Steamboat's got some plunder.
Yeah, he got some plunder, too. And it's heavy. It's loaded.
Right into Steamboat's eyes.
Boy, it looked like he hit him with some dirt. Got some sand, dirt.
Oh, man, right in the spine.
Wow.
Right in the spine of Steamboat. That metal trash can crashing down across the back.
We got a mess going out there, Matt.
Husky's rolling Steamboat over. One, two, that's three. Husky did it.
The winner of this match, Husky Harris.
And I mean, these guys are playing in traffic. Husky Harris.
Hey, look. Who is that? Is that a pedestrian? Is that just a bystander?
There's somebody. A truck out in the parking lot here. And Steamboat just got planted right on the back of his neck with a steel trash can. Steamboat out of it. And what is Husky doing?
I'm gonna tell you what. This goes back to his grandpa days. This goes back to Blackjack Mulligan.
This goes back
to Barry Windham. I mean, he put him into somebody's truck.
Steamboat's in the back of the truck. Where's Husky going? What 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 What is going on here?
Whose truck is this?
They're taking it all. Who's driving that truck?
Wow.
Unbelievable for the American dream. Dusty Rhodes, I'm Matt Marlero. It's all said. It's all done. It's been real. It's been fun. So long from the Sunshine State.